one of the major strengths of the division is really its ability to address infectious disease problems in a multidisciplinary, intersectorial approach. We have people who are doing very much basic epidemiology as well as laboratory based research towards also the ecology and the environmental issues surrounding the transmission of infectious disease.
And right now I study the modeling of infectious disease transmission. And so I study how diseases get transmitted from one person to another, or actually in my case from one animal to another, because I study rabies and the cost effectiveness of control strategies against rabies in Tanzania.
I am very interested in infectious disease as it pertains to vulnerable populations. So I can, I think that I can appeal to crowds who are interested in the more holistic health package, not just infectious disease, but also those.
The division are the spectrum of diseases which have global health importance. These include HIV, neglected diseases which occur in poor marginalized populations, diseases such as leishmaniasis, leptospirosis, as well as major emerging diseases such as dengue, and diseases which are important for this region, such as Lyme disease and other tick-borne illnesses.
I think the most transformative opportunity I've had that's at least really brought me into this into research has been the Downs Fellowship, which I did when I was a master's student here. And I worked with a very, very marginalized population. That kind of fieldwork experience and really devising basically a whole research protocol.
Most importantly, actually, I learned about the way that they continuously vaccinate dogs, even if they've already been vaccinated, and about how that is the best strategy to get
about,
the most.
For example, I wrote a book chapter with a faculty member in the Department of Medicine. I always want to be at the forefront of where the research is going and these opportunities and the faculty.
Taking classes in the realm of international relations has really helped me to guide my interest in public health.
One of the things that I found really appealing about EMD when I was applying and that I have found all to my advantage since I've been here is the flexibility of EMD's course requirements and the structure of the program. So I was able not only to take classes here in public health from some of the best researchers in public health alive, but I could also have all the rest of Yale at my disposal. So I was able to go take classes in landscape ecology or remote sensing and GIS from all across the university, and that was not only allowed but encouraged by EMD, because they know that in order to best do your work, do the infectious disease research that you want to do, you really have to have training from the best of the best wherever they can.
The problems which affect the poorest populations in the world, the most vulnerable populations of the world, but also to address the issues of social inequity, whether they're here in New Haven or in the slums of Brazil or in the poor rural-based populations in South Africa or Kenya or Uganda. And that fits in with the mission of our division, which is really to make a public health contribution and to make a public health contribution to those who are most vulnerable and most marginalized. And I think that